I now call upon the Honourable Alberts to the podium.
Voorzitter, dankie. De jeugd in Zuid-Afrika en sluitende die continent van Afrika is deel van een geschiedkundige demografische dividend wat of een geweldige economische hulpstoot voor Afrika kan geven of een geweldige factor kan wees in die destabilisering van staten en sluitende Zuid-Afrika. Europa en die VSA, as ook nou China tot 'n mate, kon die demografiese dividend effektief aanwend tot enorme ekonomiese groei en ontwikkeling met gepaardgaande groei in die ekonomiese welvaart van die gewone persoon in die straat. South Africa is struggling in using this demographic dividend effectively. Instead of super economic growth, we are dealing with dire statistics. 50% of employable persons under 25 are unemployed. The under 25s constitute 3% of total unemployed. 60% of those that left school did so without matric. The average time spent looking for a job equals 806 days, and young people are competing in a pool of 6.5 million job seekers. The struggle means that South Africa can, in the foreseeable future, face significant unrest stemming from frustrated youth. The answers are obvious. We need economic growth that creates jobs fast and sustainably. However, the problems outlined by statistics have an underlying reality of cause and effect that can be found in government policies that do not work. Die regering se beleid skiet ver tekort in die volgende areas. Eerstens, basiese onderwys is so swak dat diegene wat uit daardie stelsel kom, veral arm swart jong mense, beskou word as onaanstelbaar, behalwe vir ongeskoolde arbeid. Dit is 'n nasionale skande en mense kan net wonder of die regering opsetlik die massas ongeskoold wil hou ten einde hulle maklik te beheer. Liberation before education is steeds die mantra. Die eerste stap in die regstel hiervan is die instel van moedertaalonderrig. Meer klem op wiskunde en wetenskap en die daarstel van hoër slaagstandaarde. Secondly, end affirmative action for those who have matriculated after 1994 so as to create an inclusive and diverse economy. This will grow the economy and allow for more job creation instead of driving youngsters into unemployment. Also, end job reservations where no black candidates are available. The consequences of this policy have dire effects. For instance, the country faces a severe shortage in veterinarians as the unfilled quotas for black students are not filled with other students, thus leading to a growing shortage that will undermine the country's future. There are many other examples, especially in government, where a complete overrepresentation of blacks exists. Die aanspreek van die probleme sal beide sosiale kohesie en ekonomiese ontwikkeling moontlik maak in Suid-Afrika op die pad plaas van ongekende groei deur middel van sy demografiese dividend. Die alternatief is dat die dividend eerder 'n las word wat die land uitmekaar kan skeer. Minderhede bied hulle steun aan om die land te maak werk, maar sou die hand weggeklap word en orde verval, sal die nasionale minderhede geen keuse hê as om toevlug te neem tot die skepping van 'n alternatiewe sosio-ekonomiese realiteit nie. Dankie, voorsitter.